私はクーデリア・アイナ・バーンスタイン。私の声が届いていますか。皆さんにお伝えします。宇宙の片隅、ドルトコロニーで起きていることを。そこに生きる人々の真実を。私は自分の生まれ育った火星の人々を救いたいと願い行動してきました。けれどあまりに無知だった。ギャラルホルンの支配に苦しむ人々は宇宙の各地に存在していたのです。私はドルトコロニーで自分たちの現状に立ち向かおうとする人々に出会いました。彼らはデモという手段を取りました。しかしそれはあくまで経営陣、彼らが行動を起こした際、まるで示し合わせたかのように。ギャラルホルンに私は問いたい。あなた方は正義を守る存在ではないのですか。これがあなた方の言う正義なのですか。ならば私はそんな正義は認められない。私の発言が間違っているというのなら構いません。今すぐ私の船を撃ち落としなさい。
How do we understand monsters? Frankenstein, the mummy, Dracula, and vampires as a whole, vilified at the same time as being strange and terrifying, are now simultaneously satirized. But there is a great tragedy to this. We refer to many of our worst criminals and dissidents as monsters. But what does it mean to be a monster? What is the phenomenology, the experience of monsterism? It is the experience of manicopsis, the experience of being completely out of place in a world that lacks the dictum and definitions for you, and as such imposes upon you a terrible pain and alienation. Think about this. Van Helsing may have appropriated the narrative, but these monsters lash out at the world not because they are evil, but because to them, the world is evil. It is we who have rejected them and incurred their frustration and their loneliness. I now turn to the most provocative instance of the existential need to wage war in the science fiction piece Mobile Suit Gundam, Ironblooded Orphans by Mari Okada. Please keep in mind that this piece was written by someone who, as a woman in a patriarchal society, has to, on a daily basis, struggle existentially for the right to be herself. Now, for the premise of Iron-Blooded Orphans. In a classist solar system based on oligarchic, caste-based institutions, orphans necessarily find themselves at the bottom of this ladder and are forced into what amounts to slave labor for private trade and military contractors and corporations. One group of orphans under the private military contractor known as CGS revolt. They ambush and capture the adults running the company and execute them, brutally, taking over the finances and operations of the organization. They rename it Tekadon, or Iron Flower, and become a private military organization that is feared more than it is respected in the solar system. They are known colloquially as the Devils of Mars. Allow me to speak briefly on the history of their world. Their current order is imposed by the hegemonic Garrel Horn political bloc, which is the victor of a terrible war, sweeping in as both a liberator and bringer of stability. Does this sound familiar? Think about 70 years ago in our world. So, this calamity war reached a climax when the mobile armor, weapons of mass destruction modeled after angels, aimed at bringing peace to the solar system, went out of control. Garrel Horn's founding fathers brought an end to the war, but Mars was left in ruins at the hands of these angels. World history and politics are an awkward thing, as they miss phenomenology. What is the experience of having to grow up an orphan in a devastated land, in a world which cannot countenance that you exist. At the heart of Tekadan is not Orga, its young, pivotal, brown-skinned leader, but rather his dearest companion, Mikazuki, translated roughly as Crescent Moon. Though Mika himself will not learn the etymology of his name until the adult staff of CGS are murdered and Tekadan are established, and Mika, in his terrible Barbatos armor, carves a path for them across the stars until someone eventually tells him what his name means. Something he could have never learned in the barracks of CGS. Okay. Mikazuki is merciless to a fault, the extent of his immorality making him, in effect, Orga's and Tekadan's weapon of mass murder. I chose my words carefully there. Mika is amoral, despite his crimes, not immoral. He does what he does not because he wants to, or even because he thinks it's what's right, but because he must, on an existential level, to win trade, to prove Tekadan's worth to the Tewa's cartel, to fend off the authorities, whose very existence reminds them of their very own inequity. It's not about justifying anything, and I know there's a socialized urge for that. We've been taught to justify everything. But empathy and understanding are not about justification. They're about understanding that ours is not the only version of the world that could exist. What are your thoughts on Mika and Tekadan at this point? Do you see what they have done? They have carved out existential space for themselves in a world which denies them the right to exist, to create, or even to dream or love. No matter how much might or capital they amass, they remain human debris. As orphans are referred to, they become a perpetual conflict with the classless authorities and larger corporations, waging a constant, bloody conflict with no end. And they cannot hope to overturn the established order on their own, so their only options are to cease to exist, or to fight and dream of an end to the fighting, becoming more amoral with each battle. Fight or disappear becomes all that is left to them. Storytelling is an engagement in empathy. Telling meaningful stories is an act of openness, which by definition is an act of love. Try this thought experiment. Think of someone or something you absolutely cannot agree with, and wonder just for a moment, what is their phenomenology? What is it like to be them? I believe everyone has a choice. People choose to protest, for example. But they choose to protest in the name of a world. They are choosing the world they want to live in. In democracies, we get to do this. Or at least we should be able to. But what if we weren't? Could peaceful resistance have toppled Bashar al-Assad? I don't know. I really don't know. It might have. I like to think it could have. Today, Syrians across the world are expressing themselves through art, from theater to song, as an existential need to touch and move the world, to choose a better world. As for Mikazuki, there is nothing romantic about Tekadan, or the Free Syrian Army, or how they live. I, like them, am a dreamer, and so I support Mika and pray for a day when he can stop asking Orga how many people he has to kill. Until then, I am so very grateful that I was not born Mikazuki.
I ride with conscious thoughts, cause I got conscious thoughts. I see the bigger picture, now I've been connecting the dots. Can't rely on these rappers, painted destiny stops. Drive gotta be so made like car factory locks. I'm a human among bots, a king around, peasant, a man among tops. But I never let that get me disheartened, cause the gun just went off the rings, barely even starting. And I'm looking for the paradise I lost. See that pick of John Milton on the carton. Dark forces behind the scenes plotting, but I never falter cause of the help I brought in. Even though I'm walking on cotton, I still sit on my fist, share a glass and sharp rocks to discouragement as I pass. But it only kept it going till my tank was gas, yeah. All day I daydream, I focus on the mission. I don't care about daydream for me. I am dancing molecules and they steam. I'd rather have my own pool to drown in they stream. Yeah, all day I daydream, I focus on the mission. I don't care about daydream for me. I am dancing molecules and they steam. I'd rather have my own pool to drown in they stream.
Like a man walking on air. In the space of a year, he's gone from dancing in the ruins of Damascus to performing in Paris. It's an impromptu show, but he's fought against his family and Islamic State in Iraq and Levant to be here. Dance or Die is the name of the song. It's
no,
also
we'll not swim, but I'll learn if he's getting away from them. They're too obsessed with temporary things. Gold tarnished rings, I know something is forever like a gym. They come up right off the top of the dome. I'm a
slug, I
don't
want to
see
a
value on a lighting dim. But I still shine, even in the presence of shame. But I burn on every tree, every morning and day. Yeah, my future waits too bright to ever fade. And I just want to hit my people with that luminance. It's the revolution, I'm the dark skinned prince. But I don't want to lit a pot like I got sense. Like a change job, but I know I ain't far from the diamonds. The
prize
a little bit
more than
I'm
the power of
the state. Way faster than I'm like a
forced to practice his steps on rooftops in Damascus, when the director of the Dutch National Ballet saw footage of Ahmed, immediately raised the money to bring him to the Netherlands to dance and study.
I'm a big fan of the